All right. Good evening. Good afternoon, everybody. What's up? So we got our special event today. We're going to be chatting about hormonal balance, toxicity, beauty care. And I have Susan Jensen here with us in her car. She has her seatbelt on just in case this conversation goes too fast. She will be safe and secure. Hey, are you driving?
No. I pulled over, but I'm on 7th in San Francisco, so I probably should have my seatbelt on because the cars are coming by fast.
Yes. Yeah. And Susan was attempting to come to our home today, and she was supposed to be here a little before 5. So sounds like you're a few hours behind.
Yes.
Yep.
Life.
One of those days.
Sports, right?
Yeah.
Life. So yeah. So today we wanted to continue our conversation from last week. If anybody was with us last week, we had Beth Gillespie, a nutrition consultant, join me on a conversation about hormonal balance. And last week we talked about strategies to help balance the hormones. And this is not just a conversation for females. A lot of times you think of, well, females may just need to balance the hormones, but hey, guys have hormones. We have hormones and feelings too. but you know, for the most part, most men are not going to be listening to a conversation on hormonal balance. However, they may need to at some point. So last week we talked about a number of strategies for food and a lot about food and how we can improve our hormonal balance. And we kind of got into a few other things as well. We started talking about the problem with plastics and estrogen dominance. So if you're eating a lot of food out of plastics, you might want to think about some alternative ways. Instead of using Tupperware, maybe some glass. Instead of buying spinach in bins, maybe buy, you know, the loose leaf spinach or, you know, at farmers markets and just, you know, bring your own bag. Do whatever you can. So lots of strategies. What else did we talk about last week? Do you remember anything offhand?
Well, I know the hormone thing that surprised me was the lack of iodine and just how, you know,
another good one.
Our salt, yep. Right, the Himalayan salt that we promote doesn't have iodine. And yet, you know, maybe being estrogen dominant is a lack of iodine. So that was some takeaway that I think is a great idea.
So pink Himalayan salt has a lot of great minerals that can help us with our hydration and fluids and there's a number of reasons to have minerals, but so I always have recommended pink Himalayan salt, but Beth was talking about the need for iodine, and I know this. I've tested people. You can do a quick test. It's kind of hard probably for everyday person to get it, but I used to do a thing called an iodine patch test on my clients when we were seeing each other. I would put an iodine square on your forearm, and basically the faster the iodine went away, that meant you were probably in need of iodine. So if the iodine lasted, I think it was over, 12 or 24 hours. I can't remember offhand, but that's one way to test for iodine. But for the most part, everybody could benefit from iodine. So you can buy iodized salt and just add it to things. So that was another strategy we talked about. And that has a lot to do with metabolism and thyroid. So that's a big one. What was that?
I haven't bought kelp.
Yes. And kelp is a natural iodine. So a lot of different strategies. And then we touched on skincare for a moment. And we were going to have a talk about skincare and beauty care and about beauty products anyway. But Susan was like, hey, you know what? We kind of touched on things just a little bit. And I think people may even be confused and overwhelmed by all the things that we talked about. How about we just, you know, get a little more specific with beauty care and skincare and not guess. So that's why we're here today. Does that sound about right, Susan?
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's a special day today, right?
Oh, that's right.
Oh yeah, it's Earth Day.
Yes. It's not that your bunny died. I know the bunny died.
I was like, what are you saying, Brian?
Yeah. No, it's not that. That is special now too. Now you can think of, every time you think of Earth Day in the future, you can think of your bunny.
Bad.
Yes.
Yeah. Bad correlation.
Right. Anyway. So yes, tragedy can happen on Earth Day. So let's get into it. Let's talk about skincare products, beauty care products. And, I'm going to ask a few questions and we'll go on. And if you guys have questions, definitely chime in. I have a few questions to get us started, but if you have any comments, questions, definitely, feel free to put them in the chat box or comment box, or just unmute yourself. Okay. All right. So let's talk about healthy skincare products. So, I believe that most things are not very healthy, whether it be food or skincare products. So aren't most products on the market just not very healthy for us?
I'm sorry, there was some motorcycles going by when you said that. Are you asking if they're not or if they are healthy for us?
I just believe, like most things, like food, most things, it's really hard to find healthy products unless you search for them, right? Meaning, most stores, 7-Eleven, Safeway, for the most part, they have more bad things than good things, right? So skincare industry, there's a lot of makeup stores. I don't know a lot about makeup and beauty care, but I see MAC and Nordstrom's, all these people have makeup.
Yeah.
Isn't most of the stuff toxic and bad for you?
I wouldn't say it's mostly toxic and bad. It's just that nobody is regulating it. So when we talk about greenwashing, like with food, like if a farm is making organic food, they go through like a 5-year process to become certified organic. And it might even be longer than that, but I just remember hearing that at one point. But with the beauty industry, nobody is actually regulating it. So it's weird. I hear different terms, like it's an $80 billion industry. It's a $265 billion industry. I think it depends whether you're in incorporating like just makeup or all beauty or all personal care for like kids, or, the whole gamut. But anyway, it's a billion, multi-billion dollar industry. And there are two pages of regulation on it. And the pages are 80 years old. This was the first year that our founder, Greg Renfrew, actually was able to get some new laws passed. So we're, trying to be part of the change, but there's a lot of what we call greenwashing. So there's, because nobody's regulating it, a company can have one or two organic ingredients and call it organic on the label, mm-hmm. or they can say it's all natural, but all natural doesn't actually mean anything. It might mean that it's coming all from the earth, but our earth is toxic. There's arsenic and heavy metals. And, we know from beauty counters, we test every batch, that sometimes we make things and we have to pull them because they're loaded with chemicals, and not all chemicals are bad. So like water is a chemical, right? Like not all chemicals are bad, but some chemicals are. And so if companies aren't forced to test the ingredients, and then as well as like test the interaction with each other, then we kind of don't know what we're putting on our bodies.
Got it. Yeah, I mean, just like natural ingredients in food, that could be a whole bunch of different things. So when we look at labels, we want to be very careful when we see natural flavors, right?
Bad.
Like, I don't know what that means.
Yeah. And so there is a great website you can look at. It's called, I think you probably promoted a little bit, the EWG. I actually think that, the woman who was on last week talked about it. So EWG.org, it's the Environmental Working Group, or you can just Google Skin Deep Database, and you can actually look up your products and find out their toxicity rating. So they go from 1 until 10, 10 being the most toxic, or maybe it's 9, I can't remember. But and then they have EWG Verified, which has like this little green circle, but that usually means that that not only are you not using like toxic ingredients, but they also have third party checked you, and it's gone through different checks and balances, and they find you not only to be non-toxic, but also to have a good reputation as a brand or as a company.
I was actually going to pull up EWG just so folks, I know we've pulled up a lot over the years. Can everybody see my screen?
Yep, we can see it.
Yeah, so this is a great website. I haven't looked it up in a while, but I just know, like, whenever we're looking for suntan lotion, that was a big one. I've spent a lot of time here looking at suntan lotion because I know most of suntan lotion, I think in summer right now, because it's warm over here, in our area for the most part. It's been about 80, and actually it was 90 over the weekend, 85, 90. So sunscreen is something I've looked on quite a bit, and most of it's garbage, right?
Yeah. So that's one which actually is really good to talk about on Earth Day, because there's a couple ingredients that are really bad for the coral reefs. So oxybenzone, octinoxate, I can't remember all of them right now, but their oxybenzone has actually been banned from both Hawaii and Florida. And so we're working on it becoming more global, but you really do want to use a zinc-based sunscreen. And Beauty Counter has a zinc-based sunscreen. If you're looking for something that's like on the lower end. So it was really funny this year. I went to Tahoe with my kids last summer and we had Beauty Counter, but I actually forgot to place an order before we went. So we had like one tube of Beauty Counter and we had some other ones. I know between our families, we go on a lot of trips together and we have experimented with a lot of zinc brands and a lot of them suck. You know, like I think Chris and I have tried about everything out there, but the one we like, the other one, like, so Beauty Counter in terms of spreading in and looking the best on your skin and not looking like a ghost, because zinc can give you that total ghost cast and it can make water bead off your face, which really isn't a good look, you know, it just isn't a good look. So that one, and there's another one called Good Sport that I think are really good. Personally, on a day-to-day basis, I like to use Beauty Counter, but like if I'm with the Champ family on the houseboat, my family's going through a tube a day. And so on those kind of trips, I do buy some other brands, but I would say, so Chris, sells Beauty Counter. So does Natalie, who's on this call. I have probably tried almost every clean brand out there, and every year EWG will release a list of their top sunscreens for the year. And it usually comes out around this time and they'll have like the best ones for babies, the best ones for sport. Reach out to us, because I know between Chris and I, we've tried a lot of brands and most of them suck. Like, it doesn't mean they're not healthy for you. They just make you look ridiculous. Yeah. It's fine if you're 3 months old, but you know, when you're pushing 50, it's not a good look.
that ghostly white look is not attractive.
Yeah.
Yeah. So just, can we go over like just how to like look at this real quick? So I can't. So what was the name of that one sunscreen you were talking about? Good Sport?
Look up. Yeah, you can look up Good.
I'm not or sure maybe I it's tried that one, Susan. Yet.
It might be Think Sport or Good Sport. Think Sport. I think it's Think Sport.
Yeah, I'm not finding Good Sport. All right. So I'm on EKG.
There it is.
All right. So again, now, how am I looking at? So just let's go over how to look at this, right? So I can see the graph here, but why don't you just talk us through it real quick?
Yeah, so that little green circle on the very far left, that's EWG verified. That is like the best rating you could possibly get. I forget, out of like 200 plus ingredients that Beauty Counter has on there, I would say maybe 75% or so, or 80% of ours are EWG verified. And other than that, we're usually in a one or two level, but EWG verified one or two means the lowest toxicity rating. Those middle ones, the yellow means moderate toxicity and the red means pretty highly toxic. And one of the things you might find is even some of the most recommended face washes for teens with acne are like a 9, and they're recommended by dermatologists. So you just want to double check, because it's not like the dermatologists or doctors are bad. They just, because no one's regulating it, they don't have the information. And so it's just good to know and know why it's toxic. Like, I can look at some things and be like, you know, that's a product I really want and it's a little bit toxic, but you know, but if it's got an asthma concern, or it'll say like cancer concern, allergy concern. If it says allergy concern, I'm not going to give it to my daughter. She's got asthma, right? And if it says cancer, I'm not giving it to anybody. You know.
So let's take a bad product. So this product is good. Think Sport.
Yeah.
So that's a pretty good one. Let's take what was it? Banana Boat. So That's a pretty popular one, right? What's a, is that one? Mm-hmm. Copper tone. Which one's more popular? Copper tone.
Copper tone.
Probably copper tone. Huh? How do you spell copper tone? C-O-P? Copper. All right. See what I have to do with it? Copper. All right. Copper tone. Let's see how copper tone fares. So we got some threes and fives.
Yeah.
Seven for this one, the spray. So sprays, that's another problem, right? Because of the aerosol.
Yeah, the aerosols aren't good for the planet. And Beauty Counter, we do have an aerosol, but it's made with a pump. And the other thing is with sprays, you waste a ton because as you spray, I mean, you can watch it at the beach. Next time you're at the beach, you will actually see the particles like flying away and not actually going on the person's skin. Ours sprays on white. So then you can rub it in and it, you know that you've actually gotten yourself. But then the other thing, like, yeah, you can look up things like Neutrogena. You know, people I've taken, they also have an app. It's called the Healthy Living app, and it has a scanner, and you can take that scanner in Target and you can scan barcodes and find out if things are toxic. You know, my teens and tweens, sometimes they want the things that their friends have, and we scan them together and we find out if they're healthy or not. And sometimes I'm telling you, a lot of those things that are all natural or recommended by their friends dermatologists are like a 7 to a 9 rating.
Yeah, so look at this one right here. It says, you know, this one contains oxybenzone, a hormone disrupting chemical.
Right.
And you can go in and read more. So this is why it's, we love this website because there's so much information on it, but it tells you everything, right? I mean, it says it's,
yeah.
Even says it's not a great sunscreen. It's not even effective,
well,
right? Even if it was.
Yeah, and then you can also just Google oxybenzone and coral reefs, and you can see pictures of what it's doing to our coral reefs. And so what I like to tell people is like, if it literally, when it hits water and diffuses with the Pacific Ocean, right? Like the sunscreen is going to mix with billions and billions of droplets of water. But if it is sinking down and actually ruining our coral reefs and killing fish off, and they've actually studied this, I mean, why would you put that on your skin? You know, like if it can bleach something that's been so diluted, right, with all the water that's in the ocean, it's bad.
Right. Yeah. So Hawaii is not allowing sunscreen now, right? Or something like that?
No.
They've banned oxybenzone. They've banned a couple of ingredients. I mean, if it's in your suitcase, I don't think they're screening suitcases, but they're not selling it there at all.
Got it. That's good. So, yeah, so we can see these are some of the products. So, like, the different ones for Beauty Counter. You can see they're threes, twos. Mm-hmm. Good. Okay. Got it. All right. And you know, again, we're talking about this because your skin is your largest organ of detoxification. So a lot of people don't understand that. Like the liver is pretty important, but your skin is the largest organ of detoxification. So if we put things on our skin, then that can be a problem. We have to now not only detox certain foods that we consume, but now we have to detox, you know, additional beauty care products as well. So just another stressor. So what I do and why we even, you know, why we wanted to have this conversation was the question, you know, for people that are not feeling well, there's just so many angles. It just depends. What angle do you want to hit? My number one focus is nutrition. That's my number one angle to reduce stress. And then I get into sleep, hydration, conscious breathing. Those are my top four. And then most people, you know, come to me for more movement-based things. And then if they're stressed, I talk to them about, you know, lowering their stress through maybe lower intensity to moderate intensity exercise. But everything can pose a stress. And oftentimes this discussion doesn't really happen. I'm so focused on food. And we don't really talk about skincare, beauty care. So if you just jumped on, that is why we're here. So we just talked about sunscreen. What are some other things to talk about when it comes to beauty care? I know sunscreen's important, but what do you ladies do every day? What's your normal regime for, I know it's not everybody's different, but.
Well, Let me chime in for just a sec, Brian, because you mentioned something back when we started of like, oh, you know, got like something about maybe guys aren't paying attention as much, but they should. And like, if you're a mom of young boys or even teenage boys, be looking at their products too, because I've just been recently listening to some studies they're doing at like Tufts University. And I listened to a woman who just wrote a book on the dangers of plastics, like you talked about, and that boys' sperm count is down like 50% from I forget how many years ago. And they're actually starting to see a lot of smaller anatomy, significantly in boys. And as the woman said, who was so funny because she was such a scientist and like medical person, and she's like, that's just not really something desirable for men. And I was like, yeah. So it was funny, but they're actually starting to see like some body changes, and so we should all be looking out. And I think I love what you said, Brian, about how like that's what you're really focused on is the internal, right? And it's all important, and we can't control all of it, right? Like we might live somewhere that there's some chemicals in the water, or we might live, like I live near an airport, right? We can't control everything, but we can control we can work on our stress. We can buy the best kind of food we can buy, and we can try to buy products that aren't harmful to us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. Yep. Little steps.
I was just going to chime in. I'm a hairdresser, right? So that is by far, hands down, one of the most toxic environments to be in, and you know, to get done on a monthly basis for us women. And you know, even if it's just a little thing you can do by getting rid of most of the plastics, or I don't know, drinking more water, dry brushing, trying to detox your body, sweating more through exercise, you know, it can only help so much, right? People aren't going to give up their color or the hairspray.
I remember, because Chris has always been, you know, in a toxic environment in hair, and Natalie cuts hair too, by the way. So I have this device, FDA device that measures toxicity. I don't use it because I'm not really connected with people anymore. It's sitting in my garage. It's a $2,000 machine that measures toxicity, but she used to be off the charts. And that was, of course, before, you know, we started talking, but our initial assessment.
Yes, it was funny. He was like, holy moly, I have never seen this number. And I mean, I thought I ate healthy and was kind of doing all the right things. And it's like, oh, this must be the environment that I'm in on a daily basis, right? So, you know, it's very concerning. And, you know, I'm struggling with migraines and other hormonal stuff now that I'm 50. And, you know, I am seeking out a naturopath, but there's, you know, stuff I actually know that I should be doing more of. And, you know, just these little tidbits of information, just make the small changes that you can. It's overwhelming to think about, you know, everything all at once, but skincare is huge. It's really huge. So yeah, even if it's not through, you know, Whole Foods or beauty counter or whatever, it's just even looking at the ingredients and just making sure that it doesn't have some of the never list that we had, you know, with beauty counter, making sure it passes on the EWG is just a gift to give to yourself, you know.
Freedom.
Yeah.
Freedom.
Our word of the week is freedom.
Yeah. And I, after this recording post, I can put some links down there for the never list and all of that. And the EWG, so you don't have to like do your writing right now, but also to like reach out to us, because like I know that there's certain products that are hard to find, not toxic, and like for hair, like for my son's hair to get spiky, I keep trying different brands and most of them are terrible. So if anybody has a good one, share it. Chris found me a good one. Is it Josh Rosenbrook or
I was just trolling the website. That's how I found him. I mean, nobody told me about him. I actually love their volumizer I haven't tried any of their shampoos, but I use the volumizer and I have not tried the men's hair products. So I actually ended up just getting a cheap one for Miles, you know, but I keep telling myself, well, it's not touching his skin, right? I just keep trying to, you know, going on my hands. I'm absorbing it and putting it on him, right? So.
Yeah, and the Josh one works pretty good. It doesn't stay super stiff, but it's like $35. And I'm like, I gotta find like a $5 to $10 one, you know?
I know, exactly.
This is for Finn, you said, right?
Yeah, well, and for my husband too, but he doesn't care as much about the spikes, but my little boy, all he has to do is pull a sweater over his head and then he looks like he has a bad haircut, you know?
they both have to get a haircut like mine and you don't have to worry about it.
Well, unfortunately, nothing in our hair stores are non-toxic, so.
So, yeah, I wanted to just share that Neverless real quick because I think that's another pretty popular thing that is important, right? So this is on a link that we'll provide, but this is the list. And you can, there's an app here, right? That you can.
You can just download the list. And then I think too, just knowing that like we ban over 1800 ingredients. So the US only bans 30. Canada bans around 600. The EU bans around 1400. You guys wouldn't believe how many friends I have that are from Europe and they have all their products sent here because they don't trust the US. But the US only currently bans 30 ingredients from all personal care. So Beauty Counter bans over 1800. So we're definitely the leader, but the ones on that list, there's probably only like 40 or so. Those are the most toxic.
Like parabens and everything.
Yeah,
parabens. So I would say the most toxic ones that you'll kind of see on everything. One is parabens. A lot of companies are removing them right now, but they're still out there. What you'll hear people tell you is, like, I literally have a friend who works for another skincare company, and she said, well, we're going to get rid of them, but it's only the last ingredient. It's only a trace element. Well, men put about 6-ish products on a day. It depends on the guy. Women put maybe like around 12. I'm sure 2020 changed things lower, but teens put around 17 layers on a day. And so if they're putting 17 layers with a trace element over a span of years, 365 days a year, that we get toxic overload. But the parabens have been found in 99% of breast cancer tissue. And they will not say that it causes breast cancer because there's a lot of things that go into it, right? There's stress, there's family history, there's so many things. But 20 years ago or 40 years ago, 1 in 20 women got breast cancer. Now it's 1 in 8. And they find parabens in 99% of the tissue. So we can't say that it causes it, but we know that it's there. And so why not make products without it? You know, if you can make something without it, why not? And make it effective, right? And then the other ones that you'll see a lot of, the oxybenzone in the sunscreen, Retin A or retinol products. A lot of people love using Retin A. And you want to be careful because if it's not being tested for the amount that's in there, it can cause your skin to be more sensitive. It can cause hormone disruption. And it actually causes your skin to be more photosensitive to the sun. So you like spend all this money on really good products and then it can accelerate skin tumor growth too. So it's just, and you can't use it when you're pregnant or nursing. So why would you use it, right?
It makes it thinner, you know?
Yeah. And so we use bakuchiol, which is a plant, and it works the same, if not better, in clinical trials. But the biggest one that is, I say, the biggest offender and the hardest to get rid of from under your sink is fragrance. So anytime something says fragrance or parfum, it's a trade secret, and the beauty industry can hide up to 3,000 ingredients behind that term. And even some of the really healthy brands, like I was using hair products from Aveda. And some of it was interesting because I like to rotate shampoos. Some of my shampoos disclosed all of the ingredients. Some of the shampoo disclosed most of the ingredients and then said fragrance. I'm like, oh, that's interesting. It's interesting that they put the essential oils on the other one, but on this one, they put fragrance, right? Because maybe there's something harmful in there, or maybe we don't know that it's harmful, but if you're having a reaction to something, how would you ever know what it was if there was, you know, up to 3,000 ingredients behind it? So that one is definitely the hardest, and the best way you can do it is, you know, using essential oils, or Michelle Pfeiffer has a great, if you're into perfume, Michelle Pfeiffer has a great new perfume line that she was on the board at EWG, and they'll even send you a little sample pack for $20. So you can, cause I know people are really like, you want to try your fragrance. But that one is hard to get rid of. Trust me.
Oh, I know. I love fragrance. Oh, I miss it. I miss it a lot, actually.
So I was thinking about I remember when she worked in a salon that sold a lot of products, there's no labels on them at all.
So Beauty Counter actually had that changed. We, in the last year, I think it was the year before, I think it was 2019, we helped pass the Safer Salon Bill, so that salons actually have to do labeling now. I'm not sure if it's in effect yet or if it's in the next few years. I don't have it in front of me, but it will have to be on there so that clients can choose whether they want to let you use those products on them, as well as
salon professionals can choose whether they want to support that brand or not.
Sure. It's crazy. Crazy. No, another popular one I'm seeing is sodium lauryl sulfate, right? It's in every soap that makes the bubbles, right? Makes it,
yes.
makes it foamy and makes it soap nice, right? But right. It's, I know we get the natural stuff without it. It's not quite the experience, but I know I'm doing my body good.
Yeah. And you want to look it up because I was in Whole Foods and I would never buy seventh generation because they use sodium lauryl, I think it is. And that one's safe. So that's why it's just good to look up the ingredients or use the Healthy Living Scanner, because I wouldn't buy seventh generation. I'm like, I can't believe this brand is so big and they're super toxic. And then they actually are on our board now. And I thought, well, why would we have them on our board if they're not great? And so I did my own research and I was like, oh, there's a word that is almost the same as sodium lauryl sulfate. I think it's sodium lauryl, and that one is safe.
Got it.
Well, it said that was not okay on your never list. So I don't know. Yeah.
Even the no. That's what I'm saying. The one you said is not safe, but there's a tiny tweak to the word and it is safe. And it's really weird. It's a tiny tweak.
Yes.
I'll put it in there after. I'll research tonight and put it in there. Like which one's okay and which one isn't.
Got it. So does anybody have any beauty care product questions? Unmute yourself or chat box.
Patty, I do. What body soaps would you recommend? And then for cream, you know, for moisturizing cream.
Like for your body?
That you would put on your body to keep your skin hydrated and soft.
I stole the one that, like the idea of the one that I saw under your cabinet. It's a one, I can't remember where I got it, but is it Elba? Like something like that? It's a whole body like thing, you know, that was a little more inexpensive, I think. But, you know, Beauty Counter obviously has wonderful, you know, body creams.
Yeah, their body washes, like our body wash, I love. You literally can use like a drop or two and it gets really, really sudsy. Our lotion, we have great body lotion, but like Chris, I mean, I'm a family of five. It can get a little pricey. Like I'd rather spend it on my face care, right? On my, I spend the money there on the makeup and the face care, but for body care, Whole Foods has a couple of really good ones and just, you can look them up on the EWG. And if you forget, like you can just Google that bottle and Skin Deep database. That's what I do all the time. And it'll pop right up in the search and I can see the toxicity level. I'm like, okay, this one's good. And then I just kind of keep buying that one.
Right.
But Whole Foods has some good ones and they're like $9 for a big.
Exactly. They're
cheap. Great. And what was the other thing? Did you guys answer Patty's questions on that one?
Well, she was asking about the body soap. Yeah. So Beauty Counters is awesome. Love the smell. It's and then I also will switch off because, you know, I don't necessarily get it for my kids all the time. I think I go to Whole Foods and I just get or Sprouts or something, you know, but I know, and I do, I label read. I will make sure that it doesn't have toxic ingredients, but they have a lot at Whole Foods. You just kind of have to try them all. Some are not as good as others.
Yeah. And then in the chat, I see somebody asked for deodorant. So Beauty Counter just launched, it would call it the Clean Deo this year. And we worked on our formulation for 5 years. And trust me, I've been on the clean deodorant train for like a decade. And I have such a hard time finding one that actually works, that doesn't have something toxic in it. And it works amazing. It goes on, like if you're familiar with Native is mostly clean, but then they use fragrance and they use a couple other things that depending on the scent, I don't like to use, but it goes on like Native, like it goes on really smooth and it does last for a full 24 hours and it's refillable. So it's really good for our environment too, because the whole future of beauty is going towards refillable packaging and less packaging. So getting out of plastics, making sure that we're being more sustainable, because that's a huge load on the environment, is just all of the, you know, plastic bottles for shampoo and lotion and a lot of the little makeup things. I found out they're really bad and it's very hard to recycle them. So even our makeup isn't all recyclable, and it's not because the ingredient isn't recyclable. It's that the particles are small. And so they get caught and in the recycling centers, they're too small to like catch into the things. I watched this whole thing on, it was fascinating, but we're doing the best we can, but yeah, I'm super proud of the refillable. I think it's awesome. But again, you can use that Healthy Living app and then also reach out. I've tried probably every one on the market.
Yeah, the Beauty Counter one works. I love it.
Yeah, it works great. If you're highly sensitive to baking soda, you might have to try something else. It works for a lot of people who are sensitive to baking soda because we found like the right formula, the right amount to use and balanced it really well. I'm highly, highly sensitive to baking soda. So it stopped working for me. But in our clinical trials, 100% of the people who are normally sensitive to baking soda had no problem. And it's returnable. So if you don't love it, you have 60 days to return it.
That's great.
All right. So Martina asks, sunscreen mist versus lotion. For example, Counter Sun Mineral.
Personally, I like the lotion better. What do you think, Chris?
Well, isn't that kind of just like a personal decision? Yeah, I like lotion better. The mist tends to just kind of lay on the skin. It doesn't maybe for me absorb as nicely as the lotion. I opened up a new bottle yesterday. I put it on. It was like, it literally just like whoosh, it was gone. It was like, you know, it was awesome. I just love that stuff. And it's not sticky at all. It just, it feels like your daily lotion.
Yeah, I like the lotion and I like, I think it lasts longer.
Yeah. Okay, so you think the lotion is at the end more effective and you get more effect for your money?
I think so.
Yes.
So isn't the mist too like more of like I'm going to go out for a short period versus if I'm going to go out to a lake or a pool or no?
No, I want to say the mist is actually stronger. I can't remember. I don't have it in front of me, but it does say you can read it on the website. It'll tell you if it's safe for 60. It's either 60 or 80 minutes. I forget.
Got it. Okay. All right. Cool. Any other questions? Janet, I see you out there. What's going on? Gabby, hello. Laura, hello. How are you, Laura?
Laura's on the call. Laura does Beauty Counter too.
Yeah.
And then another thing too, we're partnering with over on this event that I'm doing today with somebody who does cleaning products. It's a company called Norwex. And I want to hear from Brian a little bit about the wine. but we are also doing some giveaways. So if anybody makes a purchase with us today, because it's Earth Day, I know, Brian, you can talk about what your giveaway is. I don't know what Jess's giveaway through Norwex is, but I'll find out and post it. And then for me, I was going to give a choice. And because it's Earth Day, I wanted to give away one of the newer kind of sustainable things that we've done this year, which is a deodorant. We just came out with a hand sanitizer that's also a moisturizer and helps lighten age spots. And then the other one would be a foundation, because we, by putting our foundation in glass bottles, we reduced 235,000 plastics from going into the earth this year. So I'll be giving away one of those. You can choose whether you purchase with me or Chris, or Natalie or Laura, anybody on our team, we'll put you into the raffle.
That's awesome. Very cool. Very good. So,
you talk about the wine.
Yeah. So, yeah, you just mentioned the wine. So, you know, I'm not a big fan of alcohol per se, but you know, I try to talk people out of drinking alcohol most of the time. I'm not the fun pusher, as most of you know. Patty's shaking her head.
You guys. So, I've known Brian for 20 years. I still want to see him drunk. It just,
it can be annoying.
It's once. I don't even think I was ever drunk.
I've seen him a little happy, but never drunk.
Yeah. I'm always thinking about tomorrow. I can't get into that spirit of just complete freedom on a given moment. But yeah, you know, Chris has had a lot of issues with alcohol. Sounds terrible.
I know.
Not that
like
bad.
I drank a lot. I definitely was able to drink a lot more when I was younger. But yes. One half a drink bad, and I've got a migraine. So I have to really watch and be careful what I drink. So.
It's interesting. So wine. We're talking specifically wine here. So when Chris would drink a little bit of wine, and she would get a massive headache, or just, you know, the next day, just be debilitating to a point where I'm like, Chris, like, what are you doing? Like, we have stuff to do right on Saturday. Like, we can't be watching you sleep here. Yeah. We got two kids. We got, you know, kids in sports. We can't do this. Stop. And then, you know, she did. And then some of our friends were drinking a tequila called 21 Seeds. So, I've been promoting that quite a bit because she has not had headaches when she drank the tequila, and it's a specifically filtered tequila. It's pretty amazing. Yeah. And also I've noticed a lot of things, just working with clients too. And, you know, the friends that had, we had a group of friends that would work out at 5:30 in the morning, and, you know, people would, you know, drink a little too late on a Thursday night sometimes. And if it was wine, they wouldn't show up. But if it was the tequila, they would show up, and they would even be able to work out, which is pretty surprising in itself. You know, going to bed like 10, 30, 11, and being able to wake up at 4:50 in the morning for a 5:30 class. So I noticed, like, that's interesting. It's not just alcohol. It's actually the type of alcohol. And one of the reasons why 21 Seeds was born was because one of the three ladies who,
one of the founders,
Had some hormonal issues, and her doctor said, hey, you know what, if you want to avoid those night sweats, those headaches, those hot flashes, if you don't want to wake up at 1 to 3 in the morning, you might want to consider avoiding alcohol, option one, or going to a distilled alcohol. She's like, I like tequila. So she basically started infusing her own tequila with certain fruits like grapefruit or What is it?
Orange.
And then the third one was jalapeno cucumber. She started making it for her friends, and friends liked it. And now they have a pretty decent business going. And it's now at all the different BevMo and wine, the
Total Wine,
so on. So I've been promoting that. And I've been trying to get all my clients off wine. Because what I'm noticing is that, generally speaking, people don't lose weight when they drink wine. People are tired, people have headaches, people have hormonal issues. So I'm kind of the anti-wine guy. However, there is something that's been more popularized lately, and it's called Dry Farms Wine. So I don't know. Again, I haven't done a lot of work on it. I did open an account with them about 3 months ago. I just haven't talked about it at all because I don't like to talk about things when I don't know too much about it. But after the talk, yes, last week, Beth brought it up. And there's just a number of nutritional consultants, doctors, naturopaths that are saying that, hey, there's certain wines that are actually better than others. So Dry Farms is a company. I actually did create a web. I did create a little page on it. Let me just share that real quick. So you could check it out here. It's on my site on under nutrition, interestingly enough. And again, first of all, I want to say I am still not promoting wine. If you want to get healthy, you know, I don't promote it. But I also understand that people want wine. I could never have a glass of wine again and be totally fine with it. It doesn't mean much to me. I actually like tequila. I don't need that either personally, but I do understand the world revolves around alcohol and food. So I'm learning. So anyway, so just something to think about. If you have noticed that you're not responding well to wine specifically, and you're having any of these things, headaches, fatigue, weight gain, metabolic issues, hot flashes, there may be something to try, okay? So this company, Dry Farms Wine, they only find wineries, and they're typically not in this country, that are family grown and organic, biodynamic. So good for the planet. They're lab tested for purity. So apparently there's a lot of additives, just like in skincare products, there's a lot of additives in wine. Who knew? It's got a lower amount of sugar and a lower amount of alcohol. Now that may not be attractive to some people, a lower amount of alcohol.
We have not tasted yet. Levy, we just got our first delivery. We have not tasted it yet.
Yeah, we did order it and we just got a box in. So I was going to drink wine here, but it just seemed a little weird to drink wine with all of you on Zoom right now. But the sulfites are the key. You know, those are the things that cause a lot of people headaches. So lower sulfites, I don't think people are going to be super excited about the lower alcohol, but that may be a good thing. So
for me, that means I can have two glasses.
Yes. And again, then the marketing angle is vegan, keto, and paleo friendly, because they all are, but nobody talks about that. So anyway, so you can check that out on my website under nutrition. And it's at the very bottom because I'm still not promoting it. It's down low. It's down low. So Dry Farms Wine. That's there's a little no S, bit. By the way. Wines.
Dry Farm. No S, guys.
Oh yes. Yes. All right. I'll work on that.
I have a friend who drinks it. She's been buying it for years. She loves it. I gotta try it. I've never tried it.
Yes. So if you're gonna drink, choose wiser. Choose wiser. If you're going to have a cracker, Patty, don't eat Wheat Thins.
Yes, Patty and her Wheat Thins.
Yes. There's other crackers out there.
But actually with Susan's and my favorite like snack, like in the car heading anywhere back in the day, Diet Dr. Pepper and Wheat Thins.
Yes. Choose
wiser. We'd eat like a whole box between San Luis Obispo and San Francisco.
Yes. Yes. This is pre-Brian, of course.
Yes.
We hear you, Patty. We get you.
Yes. I thought I'd just bring it up again. Sorry, Patty. Is there any questions before we head out? Oh, we do. Martina, what SPF protection do you recommend for different situations? Daily versus beach versus mountains. Wow.
Okay, so it depends. We have a tinted moisturizer. It's called Dew Skin. And so some people really like that. They just wash their face and they just use that. Or for me, I need more moisture. Because I have dry skin, but it to me, I always tell people it's a great one for just going for an hour. Like maybe you're running between errands throughout the day, but anytime you're going to be in the sun for any more than an hour, then you need sunblock. And the Counter Sun, we have a great new one for faces. It's good for all skin types. I like it better than using the full like the tube that's for your body. I like the face one better. I just feel like it blends in really nice. You could put makeup right on top of it. The other one can be a little bit, it's not greasy. It's just a little more dewy looking. And I like a dewy look, but it's almost, I feel like I have to pat it or wait for it to dry. So I love that one for faces, but yeah, it's what it is a matter of is reapplying. That's the problem. People don't reapply. So you got to reapply every like hour, hour and a half. But whether it's Beauty Counter or not, anyone else, it should say on the bottle how often you need to reapply.
Cool. Anything else? Anything else? All right.
I think thank you, Susan, so much for
yes, thank you, Susan, for your
sharing all your wealth of knowledge expertise. About this company that I'm also a part of.
Chris doesn't do a lot with Beauty Counter. She's
I'm in the back burner, but I still love it. I use it. I do promote it. I talk about it with more like you know clients and one-on-one. I just don't do a lot of the other socials and stuff.
Yes.
Yeah, but you have a great client base, so.
All right, everybody. So thank you all. If you have any questions, definitely reach out. And I think Susan said something. How does that little giveaway thing work, by the way?
So you just like either here or on my event, just like let us know if anyone makes a purchase today so I can put their name in. Great. So I think, Brian, you said you would give an hour coaching session away, right?
Yes.
So yeah, if anybody makes a purchase with Dry Farm Wines or with Chris's Beauty Counter or with mine if you're one of my clients or Natalie or Laura and then Jess who does Norwex, I'll make sure I post it here as well. And she talks about her cleaning supplies where all you need are the towels and water. So it's another way to just detox your house. I don't know what she's giving away yet because she sent me a video, but I haven't watched it yet. I haven't had time. So I will figure it out and I'll be in Reno at like 9 p.m. tonight and I'll post it.
Awesome. All right. Well, thank you everybody. If you have any questions, see you later. Just shoot them our way. Okay.
All right.
Everybody that showed up.
Yeah. Right. Thanks you guys.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye everybody. Bye.
See you later. Good to see you on here, Miriam.